Hello students, today I am going to teach you the chapter e-commerce which is for class 10th in this video. So let's begin. The name of the chapter which we are going to do is e-commerce. What is e-commerce? E-commerce stands for electronic commerce. It means commercial transactions conducted over a network using computers and telecommunications. According to International Fiscal Association, e-commerce means commercial transactions in which an order is placed electronically and goods or services are delivered in a tangible or electronic form. Now, this is the second topic, that is benefits of e-commerce over traditional business. First, sell over globe. When we are doing e-commerce, we just don't remain to the geographical boundaries of our own country. Like if I am trading from India, I can reach to all the rest parts of the world wherever there is network. Second is real-time feedback. It means that there is rapid response to customers' inquiries. Third, stays 24 hours, 7 days a week, 367 days. See, if you go to the market will be open maybe for 12 hours. But on internet, there is no such restrictions. It stays for 24 hours, 7 days a week, 367 days. Next is cost efficient. As you know, the capital required to set up e-business is less than the traditional business, because in traditional business you require place, people, electricity, etc. But in e-business you just require the network. Reach new and new customers. Accessible easiness. One can access anything from anywhere at any time. This gives flexibility and convenience to buyer, seller and employees. Eyes on buyers. So these were the benefits of e-commerce over traditional business. Now coming to the third topic, that is your e-tailing. What is e-tailing? E-tailing is the selling of retail goods on the internet. It stands for electronic retailing. The e-tailing represents B2C side of e-commerce. What is B2C? Business to consumer. That means a business is trying to sell to the consumer. For example, Amazon.com, Flipkart.com. How the process of e-tailing is done? It involves visiting the website. First, you will visit the website, choosing the product. Then, you will choose the product which you want to buy. Online payment, then you will do the payment. After doing the payment, delivery of the product, you will get the product. And after that, taking customer's feedback if required. So, this is the process of e-tailing. Next topic is e-advertising. It simply means sending advertising messages to consumers over the internet. It is also known as online advertising, internet advertising, web advertising. It is a form of marketing and advertising which uses the internet to deliver promotional marketing messages to consumers. Next topic, that is e-marketing. It is the process of marketing a brand using the marketing. It includes both direct response marketing and indirect marketing elements and uses a range of technologies to help connect business to their consumers. Suppose you are marketing a product or a service. Where, what is the platform? The platform is on the internet, through email and wireless media. Next topic is e-security. It involves setting up measures and rules against attacks over the internet. There is high risk of intrusion or fraud, as you know, hacking, in exchanging information on the internet.
Last is our ERP. ERP stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. It means a computer software or system used to manage all the resources of an organization. The system can manage and track everything. Now, these are the modules of ERP. We'll go it one by one. Human Resource Module. That is HR module. It helps in maintaining employee information. It keeps the records of the employees, like the performance reviews, job description, time and attendance of an employee's designation. Second comes the purchasing module. It takes care of all the processes to get raw materials which are required in an organization. Then comes CRM. CRM stands for Customer Relationship Management. It maintains customer relationship, facilitates the use of consumer experiences, etc. Then is financials, finance and accounting module. It manages inflow and outflow of money capital. It keeps track of all the transactions. Then is your inventory module. It is used to track the stock of items. Items can be identified by using unique serial number. Using this unique serial number, inventory system can trace every item's current location in an organization. Then is sales module. It includes queries, handling, quotations, drafting, after the drafting, accepting sales orders, drafting sales invoice with proper taxation, and last, dispatch of the material, etc. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay indoors.